talk about your revolution. It's Independence Day.
My dear friends, information coming in here is very slow, so you may find that I am behind the latest events. However, I was informed that Sheriff Palmer of Grant County is being threatened by state bureaucrats to take his law enforcement license away. It is this appalling actions from the heads of bureaucracies that has me up in the middle of the night writing this response. First, I must point out that Sheriff Palmer was the only sheriff in Oregon that I know of that did not allow himself to get caught up in the political deception that the people of Burns were in danger while we were at the refuge. Sheriff Palmer went to the source and found out the truth. He found out that we at the refuge stood for the Constitution, the same document all sheriffs swear an oath to uphold and defend. He also found out that we were good, hardworking family people that love this country and would not hurt another person, and that we were there to defend people, not harm or make afraid. It is my belief that because of Sheriff Palmer's commitment to the people and his oath to uphold the Constitution, he withheld his participation in Sheriff Ward and Grassley's ploy that the people of Burns were in danger and needed martial law. Let us not forget that the resource center is 30 miles from Burns. If Burns was in such danger, then why didn't French Glen and Crane lock themselves down and declare martial law as well? They were just as close. In fact, the people of Harney County from Burns, French Glen, Diamond Valley, Fields, Crane, and people from many other areas were bringing us food, inviting us to their homes, asking us to go to their churches, all of which we did. They also set up community meetings in their area so we could speak to them about their rights. The fact is that bringing all that law enforcement to Burns put the people in much greater danger than we were 30 miles out of town, and it had nothing to do with public safety. It was a selfish act of politics. Sheriff Palmer, I am certain, did not want anything to do with government law occupying a town for political reasons. Because of his understanding of the Constitution and loyalty to the people and not government officials, his office is being threatened. This brings me to another question. Where does Sheriff Palmer get his authority to police and arrest? Does it come from the heads of bureaucrats in the form of a license, or does it come from the people through an election of the people? If heads of bureaucratic agencies believe that they can take the office of a sheriff away by pulling a license, then what does this say about where bureaucracies believe the power comes from? This is a clear example of a major problem that we the people face in this country. We have heads of government agencies, bureaucrats, that control and intimidate our elected representatives, such as a sheriff, through mandates, procedures, and licensing. They control the people the same way. We as a people are always saying how our elected representatives, politicians, are not doing anything for us. However, when you look deep into it, one can see that they, our elected representatives, are controlled by bureaucrats, the heads of government agencies, through mandates, codes, regulations, contracts, permits, and licenses. If an elected representative does not follow those processes, they too are subject to bureaucratic retaliation. Bureaucrats force it so the elected officials cannot represent the people. They can only follow the system, and if elected representatives try to change it or go against the system, the heads of bureaucratic agencies threaten them with pulling a license or with legal prosecution for breaking an administrative code or regulations. In the example of Sheriff Palmer, the heads of agencies are saying that his law enforcement authority comes from them. And if he doesn't use it the way they like, they will have it taken away. I would like to make it loud and clear that law enforcement power in Grant County belongs to the people of Grant County. Those people gave it to Sheriff Palmer, and they are the only people that can take it away. Both the giving and the taking must happen by the voice of the people of Grant County. This beautiful republic process has nothing to do with bureaucrats and their self-empowering licenses. I kindly remind sheriffs across the county that your law enforcement authority did not come by license, but by election. The people are trusting you to protect them from foreign and domestic threats. I speak of this sacred duty of policing and arresting with tenderness of heart, as my friends and myself are unjustly being held away from our families, homes, and occupations for peacefully demonstrating against extreme government abuse to our neighbors. The power to chain and cage another man is a very solemn and sacred responsibility that holds eternal accountability. When the power is abused, it causes tremendous human suffering and injustices and can destroy a man's entire life. The power to incarcerate is being used too liberally in our time. Law enforcement power is too detrimental to the people to be trusted in the hands of a few. It can only be trusted in either God's hands or distributed to the people by the hands of a republic through elections. This is the only way that the power is safe and, if abused, can be quickly corrected. This is what Benjamin Franklin meant when he implied, "We give you a republic form of government if you can keep it." I encourage all people who love to be free to stand with Sheriff Palmer and help defend the people's power as a republic. Let us pray to God that we, the people, are waking from our complacency before it is too late. Let us remember that many are suffering and many gave their all to ensure that the power stays in the people's hands. With love, respect, and gratitude, Ammon Bundy.